दशमः सर्गः द 10th चैप्टर तत्र दिव्योपमं मुख्यं स्फाटिकं रत्नभूषितं अवेक्षमाणो हनुमान् ददर्श शयनासनम्। लुकिंग देयर हनुमान नोटिस द मेन बेड चेंबर लोकेटेड ऑन ए हेवनली डायस ऑन विच ही सॉ ए बेड एनक्रस्टेड विथ क्रिस्टल्स एंड डायमंड्स। दांत कांचन चित्रांगैर्वैडूर्यैश्च वरासनैः महार्हास्तरणोपेतैरुपपन्नं महाधनैः। इट वॉज इनलेड विथ आइवरी एंड गोल्ड डेकोरेटेड विथ प्रेशियस ज्वेल्स एंड ब्यूटिफुल पिलोज। इट वॉज कवर्ड इन एक्सक्विजिट रिच फैब्रिक्स। तस्य चैकतमे देशे सोग्र्यमाला विभूषितम् ददर्श पांडुरं छत्रं ताराधिपति सन्निभम्। एट वन कॉर्नर हनुमान सॉ एन अम्ब्रेला डेकोरेटेड विद द बेस्ट ऑफ गार्लैंड्स। दैट व्हाइट अम्ब्रेला लुक्ड लाइक द लॉर्ड ऑफ स्टार्स द मून इटसेल्फ। जातरूप परिक्षिप्तं चित्रभानुसमप्रभम् अशोकमाला विततं ददर्श परमासनम्। हनुमान सॉ अ ग्रेट थ्रोन लाइक सीट made of gold and decorated with Ashoka flowers shining like the sun। valavyajana hastabhir vijyamanam samantatah gandhaischa vividhair jushtam varadhupena dhupitam। all over he saw maids waving hand fans made of the hair of the chamari deer। he saw various fragrances being spread across with the best of the dhupas। परमास्तरणास्तीर्णमाविकाजिनसंवृतं दामभिर्वरमाल्यानां समन्तादुपशोभितं। द रूम वॉज अपहोल्स्टर्ड विद द बेस्ट ऑफ बेडस्प्रेड्स मेड ऑफ सॉफ्ट वूल एंड अडॉर्न विद ब्यूटिफुल गार्लैंड्स ऑफ फ्लावर्स। तस्मिन् जीमूतसंकाशं प्रदीप्तोत्तमकुण्डलम् लोहिताक्षं महाबाहुं महारजतवाससं। इन दैट चेंबर ही सॉ द बीइंग शाइनिंग लाइक ए फ्रेश रेन क्लाउड विद ग्रेट शाइनिंग इयर रिंग्स डीप सेट आईज ग्रेट आर्म्स एंड कवर्ड इन रॉयल क्लोदिंग। लोहितेनानुलिप्तांगं चंदनेन सुगंधिना संध्यारक्तमिवाकाशे तोयदं सतटिद्गणम्। Covered in fragrant red sandalwood paste, which shined like the red tinge of the evening sky, and like a rain cloud interspersed with lightning. Vritamabharanair divyai surupam kamarupinam savrikshavana gulmadhyam prasuptamiva mandaram। A handsome and desirable form, covered in celestial ornaments. This being looked like Mandara mountain, surrounded thickly with trees and wild bushes। क्रीडित्वोपरतं रात्रौ वराभरणभूषितं प्रियं राक्षसकन्यानां राक्षसानां सुखावहम्। This being covered in the best of ornaments seemed to be resting happily after a night of playful activities with the beautiful rakshasa maidens। पीत्वा प्युपरतं चापि ददर्श स महाकपिः भास्वरेशयने वीरं प्रसुप्तं राक्षसाधिपम्। That great kapi saw the sleeping form of the valiant lord of the Rakshasas sleeping on that shining bed, resting after a night of drinking। निःश्वसन्तं यथा नागं रावणं वानरर्षभः आसाद्य परमोद्विग्नः सोपासर्पत्सुभीतवत्। That bull among vanaras moved carefully as if he was afraid and approached Ravana, who was breathing like a great serpent। atharohana masadya vedikantaramashritah suptam rakshasa shardulam prekshate sma mahakapih। The great vanara climbed the steps leading to that raised platform and once again looked at the sleeping form of Ravana, the tiger among rakshasas। शुशुभे राक्षसेन्द्रस्य स्वपतशयनोत्तमं गंधहस्तिनि संविष्टे यथा प्रस्रवणं महत्। The magnificent couch on which the lord of Rakshasas was lying asleep looked like the Prasravana hill filled with wild elephants in rut. Kanchanangada sannaddhau dadarsha samahatmanah vikshiptau rakshasendrasya bhuja vindradhvajopamau. Hanuman then saw the two arms of the lord of Rakshasas, which were lying astray, covered in golden ornaments, looking like the mighty flags of Indra himself. Airavata vishanagrairapidana kritavranau vajrolikhita peenansau vishnu chakra parikshatau. His arms had scars from the wounds caused by the tusks of Airavata, the vehicle of Lord Indra. They had scars marked by Vajrayudha, Indra's weapon, and by Lord Vishnu's Sudarshana Chakra. Peenau samasujatansau sangatau balasanyutau sulakshana nakhangushtha swangulitala lakshitau. His strong, fleshy, well-built arms with beautiful, shapely palms, fingers and nails. Samhatau parighakarau vrittau karikaropamau vikshiptau shayane shubhre pancha shirshavivoragau. His mighty arms, resembling the iron door beams, and the large trunks of elephants, with the mighty fingers at one end, looked like five-headed snakes. Shashakshataja kalpena sushitena sugandhina chandanena parardhyena svanuliptau svalankritau. They were well decorated and smeared with the cool, fragrant red sandal paste, which shined red like the blood of a hare. Uttamastri vimruditau gandhottamanishevitau yakshapannaga gandharva deva danavaravinau. They were well massaged by the best of women with fine, fragrant sandal paste. They could make yakshas, pannagas, devas and danavas scream in fear at their sight. Dadarshasa kapistatra bahu shayana sansthitau mandarasyantare suptau mahahi rushita viva. The vanara gazed at the arms of Ravana placed on the couch, which appeared like two angry snakes asleep in a cave of Mount Mandara. Tabhyam cha paripurnabhyam bhujabhyam rakshaseshwarah shushubhe chala sankasha shringabhyam iva mandarah. The lord of Rakshasas looked splendid like a mountain with his long, thick arms. He looked like Mount Mandara with two lofty peaks. Chuta punnaga surabhir vakulottama sanyutah mrishtan narasa sanyuktah pana gandhapuraskritah. The breath released from his mouth carried the fragrance of mango, punnaga and vakula flowers. It exuded the aroma of rich and delicious foods and different kinds of drinks. Tasya rakshasa simhasya nischakrama mahamukhat shayanasya vinishvasah purayannivatadgriham. The exhalations from the huge mouth of that lion among Rakshasas felt as though they were filling the whole bedchamber. Muktamani vichitrena kanchanena virajitam makutena pavrittena kundalojvalitananam. Hanuman saw Ravana's face, which was lit up by his earrings. His shining crown, studded with gold and pearls, was set aside. Rakta chandana digdhena tatha harena shobhina peenayata vishalena vakshasabhivirajitam. His fleshy broad chest, on which the pearl necklace had slightly receded from its position as he was asleep, was shining with the color of the red sandal paste. Pandarena pavidhena kshaumena kshatajekshanam maharhena susamvitam pite nottamavasasa. He was draped in splendid white silks, which had also slipped a little and were covered with exquisitely rich golden upper garment. Masharashi pratikasham nishvasantam bhujangavat gange mahati toyante prasuptamiva kunjaram. His body was comparable to a huge heap of black beans. He was sighing heavily like a hissing snake. He appeared like an elephant sleeping on the banks of the great river Ganga. चतुर्भिः काञ्चनैर्दीपैर्दीप्यमान चतुर्दिशं प्रकाशीकृत सर्वांगं मेघं विद्युद्गणैरिव. With four golden lamps glowing on four sides of the bed, the four directions were illuminated. All his limbs lit up bright with the glow of the lamps, making him look like a cloud with streaks of lightning.
पादमूलगताश्चापि ददर्शसु महात्मनः पत्नीः सप्रियभार्यस्य तस्य रक्षः पतेर्गृहे.
His dear wives were seen resting at his feet in the palace of the Lord of Rakshasas.
शशिप्रकाशवदनाश्चारुकुण्डलभूषिताः अम्लानमाल्याभरणा ददर्श हरियूथपः.
Hanuman, the leader of Vanaras, found the wives of Ravana, whose faces were as bright as the moon, adorned with beautiful earrings and fresh floral garlands.
Nrittavaditra kushala rakshasendra bhujankagah varabharana dharinyo nishannada drushe harihi.
Hanuman saw the women there wearing fine jewelry, adept at dance and music, resting on the lap and leaning on the arms of the Rakshasa king.
Vajravaidurya garbhani shravanantesu yoshitam dadarshatapaniyani kundalanyangadani cha.
He noticed on the earlobes of these women golden earrings decked with diamonds and precious jewels. They were decorated in shining armlets of gold.
Tasan chandropamair vaktrai shubhair lalita kundalaihi viraraja vimanantan nabhastara ganairiva.
The bed on which the beautiful moon-like faces of these women lay, illuminated by the lovely earrings, looked resplendent like the sky lit up with the stars.
मदव्यायामखिन्नास्ता राक्षसेन्द्रस्य योषितः तेषु तेष्वकाशेषु प्रसुप्तास्तनुमध्यमाः.
Exhausted by drinking and indulging in sports of love making, the consorts of Ravana slept all across the room with their visible slender waists.
अङ्गहारैस्तथैवान्या कोमलैर्नृत्तशालिनी विन्यस्तशुभ सर्वांगी प्रसुप्तावरवर्णिनी.
One of those women, who was exceedingly beautiful dancer of beautiful complexion, fell asleep with her limbs in a dancing posture.
काचिद् वीणां परिष्वज्य प्रसुप्ता संप्रकाशते महानदी प्रकीर्णेव नलिनी पोतमाश्रिता.
One more of these women slept hugging her veena. She looked like a lotus plant flung in a large river, clinging onto a boat.
Anya kakshagate naiva madduke nasite kshana prasupta bhamini bhati bala putreva vatsala.
Another woman with beautiful dark eyes, asleep with a drum placed in her armpit, looked like a beautiful mother holding her loving baby.
पटहं चारु सर्वांगी पीड्यशेते शुभस्तनी चिरस्य रमणं लब्ध्वा परिष्वज्येव भामिनी.
Another woman with beautiful breasts slept hugging a tanpura as though embracing a lover with whom she was united after a long time.
काचिद्वंशं परिष्वज्य सुप्ता कमललोचना रहः प्रियतमं गृह्य सकामेव च कामिनी.
Yet another lotus-eyed woman slept embracing a flute like a lovelorn woman clasping her lover.
Vipanchim parigrihyanya niyatanrittashalini nidravashamanuprapta sahakanteva bhamini.
Another beautiful woman, graceful in dance, holding a large veena, was lying asleep as though with her beloved.
अन्या कनक संकाशैर् मृदु पीनैर् मनोरमैः मृदंगं परिपीड्यांगैः प्रसुप्ता मत्तलोचना.
Another woman with intoxicated eyes was fast asleep holding a mridanga close to her beautiful bosom with her soft limbs.
भुजपार्श्वन्तरस्थेन कक्षगेन कृशोदरी पणवेव सहानिन्द्या सुप्ता मदकृतश्रमा.
another woman of a slender waist, who had been exhausted by drunkenness, was lying with a panava pressed to her bosom and clutched in her armpit.
Dindimam parigrihyanya tathaivasakta dindima prasupta tarunam vatsamupaguhyeva bhamini.
One lovely woman held a dindima and slept as if she were hugging a young child.
Kachidadambaram nari bhujasanyoga peeditam kritva kamala patrakshi prasupta madamohita.
Yet another, with her eyes like lotus petals, deluded with passion, tightly held in her arms a musical instrument known as adambaram and slept.
Kalashimapa vidhyanya prasupta bhati bhamini vasante pushpa shabala maleva parimarjita.
Another lovely woman was fast asleep, having spilt a goblet aside. Yet another was asleep, looking like a garland of various flowers in spring season.
Panibhyancha kuchau kachit suvarna kalashopamau upagohya bala supta nidra bala parajita.
Overcome with sleep, another woman lied down, covering her breasts, which shined like gold, with her own palms.
Anya kamala patrakshi purnendu sadrishanana anya malingya sushronim prasupta madavihvala.
One woman, with eyes like lotus petals and face like the full moon, embraced another young woman of beautiful hips and was fast asleep in an intoxicated slumber.
Ato dhyani vichitrani parishvajya varastriyah nipidya cha kuchai supta kaminya kamukaniva.
Some charming maidens held wonderful musical instruments pressing against their bosoms and slept like passionate women embracing their loved ones.
Tasami kanta vinyaste shayanam shayane shubhe dadarsharupa sampannam aparam sakapistriyam.
Hanuman saw some maidens lying on separate excellent beds, women who were richly endowed with beauty.
Mukta mani samayuktair bhushanai suvibhushitam vibhushayanti mivatatsvashriya bhavanottamam.
There was another very beautiful woman, decked with pearls and gems and shining with beautiful ornaments, as if illuminating the very mansion itself with her splendor.
Gaurim kanaka varnabhamishtam antahpureshwarim kapir mandodarim tatra shayanam charurupinim.
Hanuman then saw Mandodari of golden complexion, dear to Ravana and the queen of the palace, sleeping there with a beautiful form.
Satam drishtva mahabahur bhushitam marutatmajah tarkayama sasiteti rupa yavana sampada harshena mahata yukto nananda hariyuthapah.
On seeing her decorated with such ornaments, her beauty and her charm, the mighty armed Hanuman, the chief among the Vanaras, thought her to be Devi Sita and rejoiced.
Aspotayama sachuchumba puchham nananda chikrida jagau jagama stambhanarohannipapata bhumau nidarshayan swam prakritim kapinam.
His intrinsic nature of a vanara found full expression as he thought he found Devi Sita. He rejoiced, clapping his palms, kissing his tail, and repeatedly climbing up the pillars and jumping down on the ground in joy.
Ityarshe Srimad Ramayane Sundarakande Dashamah Sargah.
Thus, the 10th chapter in Sundarakanda of Valmiki Ramayanam is complete.